So hi guys, Jonathan Graham here for Guitar Interactive magazine. We are sitting here with Liam from Casey. Now, how was that, mate?
It was crazy for us. I mean, we haven't been here since 2017.
Yep.
Played to a full tent. I mean, the tent was like atrociously warm, but it was full. People had fun. We had fun, man. That's all you can ask for. So.
Absolutely. Now you guys are back with a bang. You know, it's fantastic news to hear that you know everything was back on and full force. And you've released a couple of singles along the way.
Yeah.
Are we going to see a full length soon?
Yeah. So we've just kind of wrapped up recording for our full length. I mean, there's a little bit of vocals left to do. But yeah, we're looking at like early next year release, hopefully.
Fantastic.
Hopefully people are excited.
Brilliant, mate. Now, we didn't get a chance to check it because we get to talk to lovely people like you back here. But, did anything new make the set?
Not just yet.
Yeah.
Like, I don't think we're at that, like, confidence phase just yet.
Yeah.
We want to, like, introduce new stuff. Plus, like, I think for a festival like this, I think all the singles just go down well.
It's a bold move, that, isn't it?
Yeah,
you know, but
do
you find you ever do that with new material? Do you ever take it out on the road before you actually put it down?
We have done previous.
You know,
we've kind of used it as like a kind of test just to see how it goes down, or like we've taken segments of a new song and made it like an intro to another song.
Interesting.
Just to see how it goes down. Not for stuff like this. We
Fair
just play
enough.
All the singles.
Fair enough, mate. And what was your rig today?
So I've just signed on with Neural, so I'm using Quad Cortex, like I think 90% of everybody here at this festival, you know what I mean?
I think they're walking around with order forms.
So since I was a kid, I'm just like a pedal and amp guy, you know, I was a Marshall head for like 15 years, loved like building all my own pedal boards, so I was really like skeptical to switch over to that analog kind of like switch over from that, you know, kind of world. And I love it. I seem to get on with it pretty well, so it works for us, man.
Nice one. And when did you get turned on to that?
About 8 months ago, we got them, and I was just playing around with it in my bedroom for a lot, and I was like, you know, am I going to run it live? You know, do I just prefer that amp cab pedalboard setup that I'm so used to? But I've kind of made it work. I'm kind of running it in like a hybrid kind of setup at the minute. So I've got it going to a cab and I've got it going front of house as well. So I've still got that on stage sound.
Nice one.
I think that's what I was worried about. You know, just like not having anything behind me that I've always had. But
well, it always fascinates me. It fascinates me more actually with artists that have been out there and they've got the full analog setup, you know, switching to it. Because for guys that have always just done the digital thing or maybe the newer acts, you can... You know, if you've not had that experience of having like an amp on stage where you're feeling like a speaker moving that it can be a whole different vibe, and it says a lot about the quality of what it's got to. Because you must have tried like Kempers and all that sort of stuff. Like, does the Neural stuff, do you find it just is set apart from the other?
I mean, we've got like friends who are like studio engineers and they help us out in the studio and stuff. So I've used Kemper, I've used like what's the Line 6 one, like a Helix. And like it just felt very unnatural, you know, like I love the sound of like a real saturated tube head. And I think the Quad Cortex just separates that ever so slightly, like, you know, when you run that through a cab and a power amp, it just sounds way nicer.
Yeah,
you know what I mean, like it just kind of sets itself aside ever
so slightly.
It's just giving you
what you need. What about guitar wise?
I play Balagar. It's like US based company. That's my main guitar. Roasted maple neck, 24 fret scale. It's got these custom kind of pickups in it. I'm always one to like shy away from like really expensive gear because I'm just so clumsy. So throughout Casey's entire career, I've got away with playing like 300, 400 pound kind of like, you know, stuff that I don't mind if I knock or I break.
Sure.
So when we came back, I was like, I want a real nice guitar. So I kind of, you know, spent out on this, you know, on my Balagar and
I suppose once it's got a couple of dings in it, you know, it's like, it's not going to get any, it can't get any worse now.
No.
It's the first one, isn't it?
Yeah.
You know? Balagar, it's not a brand that I'm familiar with then, so did they reach out to you?
No, so I'm not actually endorsed by them at all.
Yeah,
I just really liked their guitars.
Yeah.
And a bunch of my like favourite bands actively play them as well.
Okay.
So I just did a bit of research and like I said, if I'm gonna spend that much on something, I want it to be something I'm gonna play for the next 10 years and like really enjoy.
Yeah.
I've never been a big fan of like you know, the Gibsons and the Fenders. You know, I like kind of like bespoke, weird kind of stuff.
Sure, yeah, something that you feel is like your stamp on it. Yeah. I find it real interesting that right now we're seeing a real movement here where bands like yourself, you know, you in terms of like the endorsement side of things, you've got plenty of options and people knocking on your door, but people are going down that more custom route, and you're happy to pay the money for it as well because you're
absolutely.
You know, do you find that that's the thing that with a lot of the big brands that they maybe can't give that same personal touch to the touring artists,
man,
you know?
I think that's exactly it. You know, you kind of hit the nail on the head where, you know, do I want to play a Gibson Les Paul custom that like 99% of everybody else kind of plays? You know, there's no, it's going to sound amazing, but there's no character to it. You know, I just feel like I'm just falling in line with what everyone else thinks we should be playing.
Yeah.
So that's why, you know, I wanted to find something a bit more bespoke and a bit weirder that maybe people, you know, it catches someone's eye and think, well, that's like a weird guitar to play in that genre. And I make it sound good, so yeah.
Fantastic, mate, absolutely. Cool. Now, we talked about the Neuro, talked about the guitars. Anything you've picked up over the last couple of years, you know, pedal-wise or something that you just find that, like, you can't put down right now?
Me and our other guitarist, Toby, can't live without a Strymon Big Sky. Like, that's our sound, you know? Like, we use these big kind of soaring riffs through, like, choruses and big endings of songs. Yeah. And, like, I first got a Big Sky and I kind of had, like, the neural syndrome where I'm like, there's way too many, you know, sort of knobs on this, there's too many presets.
Where to start?
You know, but, like, once I kind of dialed it in, and I still use that alongside my quad cortex as well. I don't find the reverbs are, like, are quite as good.
Yeah.
But, yeah, like, the Strymon Big Sky, cannot live without that. And I use a Electro-Harmonix Freeze pedal as well. The quad cortex does do that, but I just find it easier to keep that next to it. So, like, between songs, I can just have that kind of, like, droney note just kind of going over and over. So, man, definitely.
Absolutely.
Those two.
Now, celebrating the 20th anniversary of Download this year, what are some of your memories of Downloads over the years? You know, coming, playing here.
Yeah.
I'm sure you came as a punter
as
well.
I first came when I was about 14. And I told my mum that I was going camping really close to my house, but I wasn't. I was coming to Download. And somehow I think we knew a band that was playing here from like the area, and we managed to like get in somehow, and from that point I was like, this is all I want to do, you know what I mean? Like when you're immersed in this like in this environment and everyone's friendly and chilling and drinking and watching these bands, and like everyone's got the same like end goal, it's just to have fun and just like experience everything. And then I came back in 2017 and I was, you know, we're lucky enough to play it. Now back here in 2023 and I'm lucky to play it again, so you know.
So that first one you came to see, who was headlining that night?
Maybe like Bullet for My Valentine, maybe. Like it was definitely that era, you know, where it was the kind of like the emo MySpace kind of era. So
absolutely. Yeah. And obviously you can't go 5 meters this year without seeing something about Metallica. It's all about their two nights here, headlining. Special band for you?
As in, are they a special band for me? Or they've definitely got a special spot.
Yeah.
You know, I wouldn't say that I'm like an avid Metallica listener, but when I was a kid, you know, everybody wants to learn Enter Sandman. You know what I mean, like that's like the first riff I learned, and you know, things like Whiskey in the Jar and all those kind of songs. You know what I mean? Yeah. So like, my dad is a massive Metallica fan, so I was kind of forced into listening to that. But yeah, as I got older and found like other kind of genres, I kind of drifted away.
What would you say is your biggest influence?
For me, like, I really enjoy the kind of like the Midwest-y kind of music, so like weird alternative tunings and like that kind of open, bright kind of like almost like screamo-y emo stuff.
Yeah.
That I bring into Casey, you know, like that's kind of my writing style, is that, you know, that bright open tuning, those kind of really twinkly kind of riffs as well.
Well, that's I mean, for me, I always sort of think when I think of your playing, you know, I think of creating that big wall of sound.
Yeah.
You know, like and a lot of the time as well. Almost feels like a cinematic influence going on there. Do you find that you get influence from hearing scores and watching movies? And
definitely.
You know,
100%. So like me and Toby, our other guitarist, are like, we're really big like pop fans.
Okay.
So the hottest album at the minute is that new Jonas Brothers album. Like I just cannot stop
listening
to it, man.
Okay.
So on this new album, we were like, well, let's take influences from stuff we like. Let's make really poppy choruses and let's make heavy verses and let's just like change it up a little bit. You know, I also love like the old 80s kind of slasher movies. That's kind of what I kind of grew up on. So some of the scores in that as well, like lots of synth, lots of weird elements to that music. You've used like a ton of that in a new album as well.
Well, it's nice that you know, well, I can't wait to hear that. I'm especially looking forward for some jagged synths on there. That's absolutely fantastic. So when are we going to see you guys, on a headlining show in the UK again?
We're going to do a headline tour when our album comes out early next year. So we've already got those shows booked, February, March time.
Okay.
That'll be fun. And we're going to the US this August as well.
Right.
Doing some headline shows there, which is very scary to be over the US and headlining, but we'll see how it goes.
Well, congratulations with it. Are you going to get a chance to catch any of the bands over the weekend?
Yeah, we're going to watch Coheed and Cambria tonight. Sure. Again, one of my favourite bands. Insane band.
Really inspirational for the evolution of that
band, 100%,
isn't it?
100%. I mean, I watched that Welcome Home video with a double neck SG when I was 13. That is sick. I missed Alexis on Fire. I was hoping to catch them, but that's all good. I watched Fever 333 earlier. I don't know what I'm straight from the path on. I might miss those, but big fan of those. And I saw Polaris this morning as well.
You've seen an awful lot more than we've seen, but we do get to chat with great guys like yourself. And look, mate, have a great rest of the weekend. Congratulations on the new record when it drops, and we'll see you down the road.
Thank you so much, man.
Thanks, man.
Appreciate it.